There is no way I could do a song review album without even speaking about this man, without speaking about this song right here. I Spy with Kyle and Lil Yachty. Of course, I gotta review that. Let's talk about them. First off, shout out to Kyle. Kyle was good. This was a good song, I Spy. This song, the reason why this is on my list of songs to review is because this is definitely in that list of songs that I had on playback since the beginning of this year. I've had that song on playback on repeat every single, I'm talking about, I was listening to playing that song when I was jogging, when I was playing Xbox One, when I was on the phone, when I was trying to flirt, like, and it's so catchy. I love this song because the beat is so simple. It's not no heavily constructed, got four or five different instruments on it. Aretha Franklin ain't singing in the background, and it ain't on that type of ish like that. It's just a really, really dope song. So I feel it and I mess with it like that. What I like about this song also is, well, I'm gonna tell you, it's two things about this song. I'll be real with you. I'm gonna keep it all the way 100 with you. I feel like Lil Yachty was useless to the song. I don't think Lil Yachty really played a part in the song other than just being there, and him happened to have a bigger name than Kyle at the time, so it gave the song more attention. But outside of that, I think Kyle, like, you know, I'm keeping 100 with you. I didn't know who Kyle was up until that point. I think Kyle held his own on the song. Like, he sounded dope. And what I like about Kyle is, with his voice, even with his speech impediment, he knows how to make a song sound. It's weird because his lisp makes songs sound even more doper. Like, it's weird. Like, I like him because he knows how to ride a beat. He knows how to ride the melody of a song. And also, he do got lyrics. Like, when you listen, go on to XXL. They just uploaded the videos on, I think, 2 weeks ago on XXL Freshman, where they showing him freestyle by themselves. Watch the video that when he freestyled, it was him, and I want to say, I forgot who the other two cats was. That's how good he was. I forgot who the other two niggas was just completely. He can stand alone in his artistry, and that's what I do like about him. He can stand alone in his artistry. I love him. He can do his thing. I think he did a good move by putting Lil Yachty on the song because it gave the song more attention. I feel like if it had just been the song without Lil Yachty's name, the song wouldn't have gotten that platinum fact that he got hanging in his house now. So, shout out to Kyle. Shout out to Lil Yachty. And by the way, this is no diss to Lil Yachty. There's no diss to Lil Yachty. I love Lil Yachty's personality. I love his image. I love his business sense. As far as him artistically. You know what's weird about Lil Yachty? And I think about this now. Because he didn't sound on I Spy. He didn't sound terrible. He didn't really sound bad. He sounded alright. I just don't think he was. I don't think he was necessary. He was necessary. He was necessary for the song to get a little bit more attention. But I don't feel like he, like, contributed to making the song that much more doper, you know? Like, if anything, I'd have put Lil Uzi Vert on the song. I'd have put Lil Uzi Vert on the song before I'd have put Lil Yachty, just because, like, and I know I'll be riding Lil Uzi Vert's dick a lot, but Lil Uzi Vert, to me, is just dope, bro. That's just my personal opinion. You know, you guys can have whatever your own thoughts about it. But shout out to Kyle, and I love Kyle's personality, bro. He got a really, really dope surfer boy, light skin energy, and I love it. I got the same energy, even though I'm dark as hell. I love you, man. Talented artist, man. I can't wait to one day to be able to meet you. Maybe me and you maybe go to In-N-Out together one day. No homo. And with that being said, let's review the next.